Welcome to the Squeeze Trigger Report for Monday, February 5th. I'm your host, Tom Wrong, founder and CEO of SqueezeTrigger.com. We're going to start our show today talking about market direction and see if we still have bullish breakouts on the Dow and the NASDAQ. We're going to go over to OmniTrader and see whether or not we still have long signals on the major indexes. We'll then go over to Visual Trader and recap Friday's trading in 15-minute bars. We'll take a look at market history seasonal edge on indexes and see which indexes are running, see whether or not we still like the oil service industry. We'll then go over to Squeeze Trigger and look at stocks and short squeezes starting in real time, as well as setting some alerts. We'll then look at a couple of trade ideas from market history. I think we have three or four today. We'll go over to Earnings Edge. We don't have as many companies reporting today, but there's still over 90. So we're going to look and see how those companies do after their earnings report comes out. We'll go over to Seasonal Edge and see which stocks have the seasonal tendency to do best after February 5th. We'll do the same for commodities and see which commodities futures do best from February 5th on. We'll go over to Currency Edge and see which currency trading pairs do best from February 5th on. And we'll finish up today with Pattern Scan, and we have a new ARM 3 trade we want to talk to you about. So the Dow traded back and forth all day Friday and held its ground above the 12,600 level. The OmniTrader chart shows we're still long and comfortably above the long-term trend line. The Visual Trader 15-minute chart shows general weakness throughout the day, with the Dow closing down 20 points to 12,653. We'll add the positions when the Dow gets above 12,700, and we're moving our short-term stops up to 12,600, and we're going to keep our long-term stop at 12,450. The NASDAQ traded quietly on Friday as the index built out a two-day triangle pattern. That could figure into Monday's trading session. The OmniTrader chart shows we're still long and in between the short and long-term trend lines. The Visual Trader 15-minute chart shows a day of consolidation, with the NASDAQ closing up 7.5 points to 2475. We're going to add to our positions above 2485. We've moved our short-term stop up to 2455, and we're going to keep 2390 as our long-term stop. We have one market history trade idea today on the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and this may bode well for the January barometer, so it may be especially significant to wonder how the Dow has fared in the past when it has made a new all-time high in the month of February. The answer to that question is, according to the 12 previous occurrences of this event, Event Edge indicates that the Dow Jones Industrial Average has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 23 trading days after the event. It rallies 75% of the time, 9 out of 12 years, by an average of 3.8% relative to the close on the event date. The average of the three declines is down 0.6%, and the overall return in the 12 cases is 2.7%. I'm also going to put up in front of you a chart here of the seasonality of the major indexes. Take a look at the Philly Oil Service Sector Index, the OSX. This thing has been working out. Oil has rallied over $8 since we said to buy oil based on this seasonality. 7.5% return still expected over the next 19 trading days. It's happened 89% of the time, or 8 out of the past 9 years. Take a look at natural gas, the Amex Natural Gas Index. We also said to buy this based on the seasonality. It's been running 75% of the time over the next 29 trading days. The Amex Natural Gas Index has rallied by over 5.5%. Take a look at the Philly Bank Index, expected to be up over 3.5% in the next 29 trading days. The Amex Oil Index is supposed to be up nearly 3% in the next 31 trading days. So some very interesting trades there on the indices. So let's go over and take a look at our Squeeze Trigger crossover events and Squeeze Trigger alerts for today. We have two crossover events and three alerts to talk to you about today. The way that we arrive at these each morning is we go to www.squeezetrigger.com. We click on strategies. We click on Squeeze Trigger, and up pops a list of all stocks crossing up above one of their Squeeze Trigger levels. We sort that list by total short interest. We're only looking to those stocks that have more than 1 million shares of total short interest. The first one is Longview Fiber. The symbol is LFB. 2.58 million shares of total short interest. SqueezeTrigger price today is $21.17. Stocks at $24.30. $62 million needs to cover. We've got a $28 price target on LFB. If you look back in 05, you had anywhere up to about $60 million a month being shorted. But you get into 06, it goes up to almost $160 million a month being shorted. So it's not one of our favorites, but it did make the list. The next one is one of our favorites. It's Novatel Wireless. The symbol's NVTL. 4.48 million shares of total short interest. SqueezeTrigger price is $11.58. Stock's at 12.5. $56 million needs to cover. We've got a $16 price target on NVTL. Back in 05, you had up to $180 million a month being shorted. In 06, it's about $140 million a month. The trades turned against the shorts. NVTL is one of our favorites. All right, we have three alerts to talk to you about. First one's Ivanhoe Energy. The symbol's IVAN. 3.26 million shares of total short interest. SqueezeTrigger price is $2.33. Stock's at $1.77, so it's got about 55, 56 cents to go. $5.7 million needs to cover. We'll have a $4 price target when IVAN gets over the squeeze trigger. In 05, you had anywhere up to about $15 million a month being shorted. But in 06, it gets up to $50 million in 1 month being shorted. So keep your eye on IVAN. The next one's Rambus, RMBS, 7.38 million shares of total short interest. SqueezeTrigger price is $23.55, stocks at $21.61, so just under $2 to go before the squeeze starts. $150 million needs to cover. We've got a $28 price target on RMBS. Back in 05, nothing much to talk about, all in the $250 million range, that's relatively speaking. But man, look at January 06, over almost $4.5 billion in 1 month shorted, and then $2.5 billion a month thereafter. So Rambus is not the trade yet, but it will be a favorite when it closes over $23.55. The last one's Pope and Talbot. The symbol's POP. 2.57 million shares of total short interest. SqueezeTrigger price is $8.23. Stock's at $8 today. 23 cents to go, so don't pull the trigger yet. There's $20 million that needs to cover. When it gets over the SqueezeTrigger, it will have an $11 price target. Back in 05, you had about $15 million a month being shorted. 06 goes up to almost $30 million a month. So, like I said, today our favorite is NVTL. You can keep your eye on LFB, but it's not the favorite. And then we got three alerts. So take a look at the chart we put in front of you. Then we'll go to a commercial break.
Tired of losing money in the market? Would you like to know which stocks could be positioned for big gains? Buyins.net has the answer. When traders bet a stock will drop in price, they sell it short. If they bet wrong and the stock rises, they buy it back to cover their losses. It's called a short squeeze and can create a demand for a stock and drive the price higher. Buyins.net created SqueezeTrigger to identify short squeezes in real time.
This information was one of Wall Street's most closely guarded secrets until recently, and Buyins.net is the only place you can get it. We monitor the market and alert you when your stock crosses its squeeze trigger price. All you have to do is pull the trigger.
You can monitor up to 10 stocks for just $9.95 a month, or for only $19.95 a month, we'll monitor the entire market for you in real time. That's over 15,000 stocks and alert you to the ones that are crossing their squeeze trigger price. It's that easy. Call 1-800-715-9999 or visit www.buyins.net to unlock the secrets of Wall Street today.
Welcome back. We have three market history trade ideas to look at today. The first one is Arch Coal. Remember, ACI is a stock that we looked at on pattern scans, and we've been long here for almost a week. How has Arch Coal responded to earnings reports over the past 12 announcements? According to 12 previous occurrences of this event, Event Edge indicates that ACI has shown a very strong bullish edge that peaks 30 trading days after the event. It rallies 100% of the time, that's 12 out of 12 times, by an average of 8.3% relative to the close on the event date. So we like ACI still. The next one is Rehab Care Group, the symbol is RHB. How has RHB performed in the past, omitting repeat occurrences within 10 trading days, when it has crossed below its 200-day moving average after recording a large 5-day gain the previous day? Answer, according to the 14 previous occurrences of this event, Event Edge indicates that RHB has shown a very strong bullish edge that peaks 10 trading days after the event. It rallies 14 out of 14 times by an average of 7.1% relative to the close on the event date. The next one's Constellation Brands, STZ is the symbol. How has STZ performed in the past when it has had a trend day decline followed by another decline in price, when the S&P 500 index closes up, and when the STX is trading below the 200-day moving average, and the event occurs after 1998? According to the 9 previous occurrences of this event, omitting any repeat occurrences within 40 trading days, STZ has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 47 trading days after the event. It rallies every time, 100% of the cases, by an average of 15.5% relative to the close on the event date. So some interesting trade ideas there. All right, 96 companies with earnings coming out today before or after the bell. We're going to focus on 12 and 6 quarter edges, which means these companies over the past 12 quarters and 6 quarters have rallied after their earnings report comes out. First one, Cognizant Technologies, CTSH. They announced before the bell today, they've got a 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge. Go look at the news now and check the price. If the stock is up, buy it. The next one's Grant Prideco, GRP is a symbol. 12 quarter, 6 quarter, and February edge. We've got a triple play here. GRP announces after the bell, so go in the after hours. If the stock's up, buy it. Next one's Principal Financial Group, PFG. 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announce after the bell today. Thomas & Betts, TMB, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they also announce after the bell today. PMI Group, PMI, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced before the bell today. Black Bond, BLKB, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced after the bell. Pharmaceutical Products, PPDI, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced after the bell. Mentor Corporation, MNT, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced after the bell. National Fuel Gas Company, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they also announced after the bell. Let's go to the next chart here, go straight down to Kilroy Realty Corp. KRC is a symbol. They got a 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge they announced before the bell. Liberty Property Trust, LRY, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge they announced after the bell. Agilisys, AGYS, 12 quarter edge they announced before the bell. Go over to our last chart here for today on earnings edge. First Charter, FCTR, has a 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge they announced after the bell. All right. Let's go over and take a look at those stocks with earnings report coming out in February and March, see which ones have some 12 quarter or 12 quarter and 6 quarter edges. First one's Broadcom. They announced February 8th. They've got a 12 quarter edge. Looks interesting. Next one is America Mobile, AMX, 12 quarter edge. They announced February 8th. American Capital Strategies, ACAS, 12 quarter edge. They announced February 13th. Credit Suisse Group, CS, has a 12 quarter edge. They announced February 15th. Corrections Corp, CXW, 12 quarter edge, they announced February 8th. Brown-Forman, BF.B, 12 quarter edge, they announced March 1st. And Sunstone Hotel Investors, SHO, has a 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced February 7th. So that's the only one there that's got a 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, so SHO would be my favorite. All right, going to Sonosite. SONO, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced February 15th. You should feel free to buy that one. Matrix Initiatives, MTXS, has a 12 quarter edge. They announced February 12th. Donegal Group, DGICA, 12 quarter edge. They announced February 20th. All right, let's move over to our seasonal edge. Seasonal edge is sorted by expected percentage return, and it's looking at what stocks tend to do best from February 5th on. Top of that list, still Quicksilver, ZQK, expected to earn over 18%. It's 27 trading days. That's happened 17 out of the past 20 years. Global Industries, GLBL, expected to earn 16.6% over the next 29 trading days. That's happened 12 out of the past 13 years. Petróleo Brasileiro, PBR.A, 100% of the time over the next 28 trading days, expected to earn over 15%. And Cryptologic, CRYP, expected to earn 14% over the next 20 trading days. That's happened 71% of the time. The flip side of that, stocks with seasonal weakness from February 5th on, BioEnvision, BIVN, expected to lose just over 21% in the next 21 trading days. That's happened 7 out of the past 7 years, so steer clear of BIVN. MBE Corp, MBEC, expected to lose 18% over the next 11 trading days. That's happened 89% of the time. Progenics, PGNX, expected to lose 17% over the next 31 trading days. That's happened 89% of the time. And RQL, ARQL, expected to lose 16.5% over the next 31 trading days. That's happened 8 out of the 10 past years. Let's go over to our commodities and see how those are faring. Take a look at high-grade copper. 75% chance it's going to gain 4% in the next 19 trading days. I like that trade. The NASDAQ 100, 70% chance it'll earn just over 0.5% in the next one trading day. And you take a look at Harbor Unleaded Gas, 64% chance over the next 5 trading days it's going to lose 2%. So some interesting ones, nothing jumping out other than the copper. All right, currency, the Russian ruble, against the dollar. Now take a look. USD is the first ticker in that symbol, so it means you're buying the dollar against the ruble. The dollar is supposed to gain in value by 5.31% over the ruble in the next 26 trading days. That's happened 78% of the time, so you go long the dollar against the ruble. The dollar is supposed to gain in strength against the Italian lira by 1.77%. That's happened 67% of the time in the next 26 trading days. And the euro is supposed to get weaker against the Indian rupee. The rupee's been getting strong. So the euro is going to get weak against the rupee over the next 18 trading days by 1%. All right, let's move over to our pattern scans. Got a lot to talk about. Pattern scan, short term. HITT, got a long signal here. It's a trend line break, 5 strength rating, green bullet. We've been long HITT for 15 trading days. We're still long. Next one is PII, brand new long signal, 4 strength rating, breaking out above resistance. We like PII. Boeing, brand new long signal, 4 strength rating. It's a power strategy, breakout to the upside. We like Boeing. BPOP, 4 strength rating, long signal, been long for 14 trading days. We still like BPOP. DE, 4 strength rating, long signal, been long for 14 trading days. We still like DE. RYL, 4 strength rating, still long 37 trading days into it, so we still like RYL. And CONR, still long, green bullet, 4 strength rating, and it's been long for 81 trading days, so that trade's getting a little old there. All right, long-term trades here. We got a brand new long signal on RNOW. Long-term, it's a gap strategy, green signal, 4 strength rating. We like RNOW. PII is also showing up here long on the long-term chart, 4 strength rating. We like it. AMN, brand new long here, 4 strength rating. It's a swing trade. We like AMN. FLS, 4 strength rating. We've been long for 3 trading days. It's still long. KSS, 4 strength rating, long for 4 trading days. DE is also a long term here, and RYL is also a long term. So we like those ones that are both short term and long term signals. Let's take a look at some individual charts here. This is a New York Stock Exchange short-term pattern, United Rentals, URI. It's breaking out. We were long on Thursday, reiterated on Friday. We like URI. The next one is also a short-term trade on the New York Stock Exchange. It's Lennox International, LII. Swing trade, we were long Thursday, reiterated on Friday. We like LII. It's breaking out to a new high. Here's a long-term trade on the New York Stock Exchange. I'm calling the bottom in New Century Financial. This is a stock that's dropped from 50 down to 30, and it's starting to bounce. So this stock is obviously tied to the mortgage market, and even though that market has been getting crushed lately, we're calling the bottom in NEW. You can buy it. It was long Thursday, reiterated on Friday. Go buy NEW. Next one is a NASDAQ short-term trade. We've been calling along on TZIX, Trizetto Group. Looking great. They've got earnings coming out today. Take a look. If that stock's up today, buy TZIX. Next one is a NASDAQ short-term trade. Calling the bottom in Decode Genetics, DCGN. This stock has dropped from over $6 down to under $4. It's bouncing here. We called the long on Thursday. We reiterated on Friday. It's a swing trade by DCGM. All right, NASDAQ long-term trade, Boston Private Financial Holdings, BPFH. Been long since about 26, got reiterated on Friday. The stock's at 29, breaking out here. We like BPFH. All right, here's RYL again, Ryland Group. This is breaking out to a new high. Take a look at that chart. It's a brand new long. We like RYL. Take a look also at Cypress Biosciences, CYPB. It's a swing trade, but it's broken out above resistance. It's a brand new long by CYPB. All right. Also, NASDAQ short-term trade, Elizabeth Arden, RDEM, breaking out to a new high. Was a long on Thursday, reiterated on Friday. It's a swing trade. You can buy RDEM. We got our only sell here today, aluminum. ILMN, sell alumina. It's breaking down below a long-term trend line. It's a swing trade. We don't like ILMN here. Steer clear. And our one arm free trade for the day is also calling the bottom in Cree, CREE. This stock has come down from in the high 20s down to the mid teens here. It's gotten hit very hard. Had a big volume day, big breakout up to the upside on Friday. Got a brand new long signal on CREE. You know how well these arm three trades have worked on Krispy Kreme, Nitromed, TiVo, by CREE. So once again, every day we bring you 3 to 4 different technologies that scan the entire market and all trading instruments within that market. What are those technologies? Squeeze Trigger. You can go to SqueezeTrigger.com and get that for $19.95 a month. OmniTrader gets us all of our charts. All 15,000 stocks are scanned. It's $490.95 one time. Then for $49.95 a month, you get all those pattern scans loaded into your OmniTrader every night. You don't have to do any crunching. It's just so quick and so efficient. We also have market history. Market history is covering earnings, seasonality, commodities, currencies. It covers the indexes. It covers everything. You go to SqueezeTrigger.com, you click on strategies, you click on market history, sign up for 1 month free. This is one of the most powerful technologies I've ever found in the stock market. So SqueezeTrigger, OmniTrader, Pattern Scan, Market History, those technologies are allowing us to predict with such high accuracy all of these very profitable trades that we bring to you every day. So tune in each day at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, 10 a.m. Pacific. You can go to mm1.com to see us live, or we instantly archive at SqueezeTrigger.com. Just click on the TV. I'm your host, Tom Rong. We'll talk to you tomorrow.